Today I was doing my water test and I noticed all of the water parameters were off. So I've got to do a water change and up my dosing. Meanwhile, I want to share some footage with you from yesterday of a new addition to my aquarium. Check it out. See you guys back here. Got another rose bubble tip anemone over here.
They need to get used to the seawater in the aquarium, so what we do is we set up a drip loop. And one thing that tends to be really difficult with anemones especially is that they move on their own. They'll just choose whatever spot they want in the aquarium, and they will stake themselves there and kill everything around it. Hopefully, it'll just decide to stay exactly where I place it. You do not want it to get stuck in the power head. It'll get shredded up and kill everything in the aquarium.
I waited half an hour and check it out. The anemone already moved. The clownfish is so happy, look at him.
Welcome back, I was able to get everything stabilized. Anyway, due to the aquarium disasters I've been having, I thought that I would count down my top aquarium disasters that occurred in the first year of reefing with this Red Sea Max C250 saltwater aquarium. Number one, aggressive fish in the aquarium. Basically, the biggest fish is the leader. The solution, which I found was so silly, is to actually just tape a picture of a larger tang to the aquarium, and then the yellow tang became very docile and stopped attacking the fish. It was so funny, but it worked. Number two, when I first set up the aquarium, I spent a lot of time on the rock structure, and unfortunately, when I put water in the aquarium, the rocks totally just collapse on each other. Once the rocks move and fall down, it is nearly impossible to get the rocks back to where they were before. I went and purchased a lot of aquarium rock putty, and I was able to get the rocks to stick and stay in place.
Number three,
the glass thermometer in my tank breaking. The thermometer has a metal tip with tons and tons of tiny little metal beads inside. My magnet cleaner one day got too close to it, and it caused the little metal beads to break through the glass thermometer, and it shot into the power head over here and caused hundreds of tiny metal beads to fly through the whole aquarium.
Does that thermometer have mercury in it? It will kill everything.
Figured out that it was actually iron. I ended up using a really strong magnet and waving it over the entire aquarium for hours and hours, and I was able to capture pretty much all the beads. There's probably a few left inside of the aquarium.
Number four.
For some reason, I was able to get my trochus snails to start reproducing like crazy. They get into everything. Tons and tons of baby snails inside, clogging the pumps.
As you can see, there's a snail right over there.
When the snail gets into the magnetic pump, it can cause the magnet on the outside of the pump to misalign, basically cause the power head to fall down and change the flow in the aquarium. Number five, the fish killer crab.
I knew something was wrong when I noticed everything on this rock would die.
He killed my two Banga cardinals and ate them. So many coral pieces in my tank. I have no idea where he came from unless he hatched from an egg. Let's try some frozen mysis shrimp. I'm gonna fill this up with water, stick frozen mysis ice cube inside, and let everything settle to the bottom of the glass. Now I will stick this glass underwater against a rock and then untwist the cap. And when the crab decides to climb up to the top of the glass, he'll fall inside and not be able to climb out. Overall, I would say that this reef aquarium was a huge success. And later on in the vlog, I'll share with you all the equipment that I used in the aquarium. But first, let's start the vlog. Thank you.
needed that.
Gatsby is chewing away on his bully stick.
Okay, I'm headed off to the gym, gonna hit some back, and gonna mail some calendars out. We'll see you guys there. Okay, dropped off all the calendars, and let's continue on with the day. And for lunch today, I thought that we could make some really easy almond lemon basil pasta that I found online. Link to the recipe in the description below. Let's get started. All you'll need, whole natural blue diamond almonds, spaghetti pasta, garlic cloves, some lemons, basil, and olive oil. See how easy this really is. First, let's preheat oven to 350 degrees. Next, let's start by boiling some water. Next, we're gonna chop up 1 cup of natural almonds.
Nice.
Stick these on a baking sheet and stick this in the oven for 6 to 9 minutes. On a separate pan, we're going to heat on medium-high heat
3 tablespoons of olive oil.
Now, let's thinly slice 6 cloves of garlic. We're gonna saute for 2 to 4 minutes. Almonds are done, so we set these aside. In the meantime, let's make some lemon juice. Now we remove this from the heat. We add our almonds and 2 tablespoons of lemon juice. Good, add some salt to the water. We're gonna wash and chop up 1 cup of basil.
Smells so good.
And let's make some lemon zest from the lemons that we have. The noodles are done. Beautiful. Now we just add everything to it. And our basil.
Ooh,
looks beautiful. I actually decided to add it back to the pan that the almonds were cooking in because that had a lot more olive oil in it.
Nice.
Now we sprinkle it with the lemon zest that we had and some Parmesan cheese. And there we go.
Lunchtime.
It tastes really good.
The almonds add like a nice little crunch. Basil tastes really good with the lemon. And the Parmesan really adds like a lot. This is really good, I really like it. I don't know if it's really that easy, but it tastes really simple and like really delicious. I would highly recommend it. Out of 10, I would give it a 9.5. It's so good. I'm gonna enjoy this and I'll see you guys afterwards.
To Ryan and Gatsby. This package is from the UK. I've sent you a bunch of British chocolate candy for you to enjoy from Katie, Joe, and Toby the Jack Russell. Thank you so much. I'm excited to try these out. Maybe I'll do that in the next vlog. P.S. I'm looking forward to using my Corgi on Fleek calendar in 2017. I just posted a video on Gatsby's channel. This is a behind the scenes on the making of the Corgi on Fleek calendar. You can check it out on Gatsby's channel, Great Gatsby Corgi. And I thought that I would reveal another picture. Let's see, what picture should I reveal this time? This was actually a test shot that we took. We actually went in the photographer's car over here and he just stood outside taking pictures. I think there's something about it. Gatsby's face is just like so happy. We ended up going with that first original initial picture that we took. We still have calendars in stock, so make sure you check that out. Go to corgionfleek.com. We also have our t-shirts here if you want. And as I mentioned before, let's check out all of the equipment that I'm using in my aquarium. This is a all-in-one aquarium, so it comes with most of the things. Let me show you the additional equipment that I added in order to get the aquarium looking like this. This is a Vortec MP40. It is a magnetic power head. Most of it is on the outside of the aquarium, so you don't have to have this whole thing in the aquarium. Over here, I have a Tons magnet cleaner. There is a scraper on the inside of the glass, so I can clean the aquarium glass without having to stick my hand inside of the aquarium. And the cool thing is, it can go over corners. So in the back chambers here, we have a filter sponge and the circulation pump is over here. Aquarium heater, dock protein skimmer, aquarium fan, and we have another circulation pump right over here. And over here we have a media rack, which I stuck 2 Chemi Pure Elite carbon bags inside. Over here we have our veggie clip. This is aquarium safe, there's no metal parts. As for lighting, I'm using ATI bulbs. I just got some new ones during Black Friday and I'm in the process of changing them out. You can only change out one per week. This time I'm going to be using
4 blue plus bulb, 1 coral plus, and 1 purple plus bulb.
I bought some ribbon LED bulbs, as you can see between here, that I've stuck inside of the aquarium, and that's what I use as a stunner at night in order to make the corals pop.
As for below the aquarium, this is what I have. About 1 gallon of water evaporates from my aquarium every single day, so we need to top it off with fresh water.
Here's the water level sensor, and if the water drops below, it sends a signal and sucks some water up and pours it back into the aquarium. Over here we have our battery backup. This is plugged into my Vortec powerhead pump. The main thing that will cause the aquarium and everything to die is that all the oxygen in the water is consumed. You need some kind of water circulation that will aerate the water because the fish consume oxygen in the water. And over here I have a waterproof power outlet just in case any water pours down. Over here we have our Kent Marine scraper, which I use to clean the back of the aquarium. And over here, fish food and other junk over here, and water tests.
It's been nearly a year since I got my RODI unit. Pretty much a freshwater filter. They look really disgusting. They all used to be white. Bought replacements for everything.
Yuck. Ew. Replace it with the new one.
Finally, the dirtiest one. The resin turns brown when it's exhausted. This is super brown. Okay, so we got that done.
Look how clean.
Okay, I just turned it on. Water is passing through all the chambers here,
and it's coming out.
And that is the aquarium tour. Hope you guys enjoyed that. If you want to see an in-depth view of anything about my aquarium, make sure to check out my playlist. I'll put a link in the description below. And I hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up. Now let's continue on with the day.
Do you want to play?
Would you like me to set this up for you?
Okay.
Which one? That one? Okay, here it goes. Inside. Oh, good job. Back up, back up. Oh, Gatsby's reflexes are so good with this iFetch, like he catches it every single time. Let's see if my reflexes are just as good. Excuse me, I'm gonna play, Gatsby. I'm gonna play. Back up, back up, back up, I'm gonna catch it. Ah! Oh, that shot me right in the throat. Okay, back up, back up. What a cheater! Come on, let me play. It's pretty scary staring down the barrel of that. Wasn't that scary? Okay, Gatsby, you're good at it. Oh. Sean just texted me, he was like, do you want to go to Target? And I'm like, sure, I have nothing to buy, but whatever.
Merry Christmas, Sean. R2-D2 humidifier, I need a BB-8 one though. You have that? Everything's on sale, but you have to buy 4. I just need 1. Where's all the Moana stuff? There's Dory, frozen string cheese.
Nestle?
Is that what you call it?
Nestle?
You mean Nestle? I've never even had that.
Really?
That's like made in the Bay Area too.
Yeah, it's like the original.
By the airport.
Yeah, that's that. It's it.
It's it. Is it good?
Yeah, it's pretty good. I like it.
Bye. Sean, you can get a Disney princess dress that does not have Moana on it. Oh, it's not quite your size.
Yeah, fit of the shirt.
All the cookie stuff here. I still have so much cookie dough left in the freezer from the cookie vlog that I made. Where's the Moana drink? Coconut water, they need to have some Moana pineapple juice. There's still no Moana anything here. Moana, where are you? Look how many dolls you get. And there's still no Moana. Best Christmas album ever. NSYNC's Home for Christmas?
The original one.
Yeah, Merry Christmas, Happy Holidays. It's like their best song.
Look at this, Sean.
It's literally spray paint.
No, but it's the princess kit. It comes with the eyes and it's just food coloring and water, probably.
Hipsters.
Wow, so much shade.
But the snow stuff.
It doesn't make sense. Who are the two people that bought these? When has it snowed in California? Enough to make a snowman.
Moana, it's also that you can get the box. You can get Moana's wristband.
If you want to have a Moana party, you can't. You can only have Star Wars, Finding Dory, Minions, or Frozen. We found it. Moana cereal.
It's right here. It's exactly what we need in our life, Sean.
We're ready to go. Got my YouTube bag. Let's go.
Just did my laundry. All nice clean sheets. And I thought that I would show you guys how to make a bed. Let's do it. We got our fitted mattress sheet already on the bed here. First thing you do, lift up the mattress, take your other hand.
Step two,
stick my arm inside, touch the edge of the bed right over here. Take the fabric, pull it along, pull it against the side of the bed. Then you lift and tuck this underneath, then drop this fabric here. Then I just hold onto it like this. You got your hospital corner. Beautiful. Step three, and bam! And that's how you do it.
Oh, I'm so ready for bed. I'm gonna go to sleep early so that I can wake up early and edit this vlog. Good night.
Today, Gatsby the Corgi will be experiencing his first cat. Are you ready? Where's the cat?
Gatsby's gonna check to see where the